Thank you, President Byerly. Good afternoon, class of 2019, family, friends, members of the Lafayette community, and distinguished guests. 3 months ago, I was invited to a scholarship finalist luncheon in New York City in one of the bougiest places I have ever been. I was incredibly nervous and honored to be invited to attend such an event, similar to the emotions that I'm feeling right now. There were 6 other seniors like myself competing for a scholarship for graduate study in Scotland, each from a prestigious college or university. I felt like the smallest fish in the biggest pool of my life, something that even my 15 plus years of swimming couldn't prepare me for. These 6 finalists blew me away with their poise, academic brilliance, and incredible accomplishments. We made small talk, the kind I presume you would expect at a Capitol gala, about our thoughts on the political climate, the phenomenal mentorships we received from our institutions, friendships we had during our years, and our respective career aspirations. These remarkable students seemed to have it all figured out. One had completed research on technologies to cure cancer cells. Another, as a junior, started programming robots to serve as therapists for stroke patients. Yet another composed musical pieces for concerts at Carnegie Hall. And there was even a student who had started a foundation for marine life preservation in the Galapagos. Listening to each of their stories, I thought, how the hell did I get here? What I had come to realize that day was that this leadership is within all of us. Though it may not be demonstrated in the same way, we all have the ability to do incredible things. Class of 2019, as I reflect on the difficulties we have faced, the challenges we have accepted and mastered with swagger along the way, and the incredible moments of sheer happiness that we have shared, we have come a long way, and in some way, shape, or form, each of us are just as impressive as those 6 finalists. As we celebrate the accomplishments that we have forged on our journeys over the past 4 years at Lafayette, I want to take some time to think about the ways in which every one of us has proven ourselves to be the best leader we can be at what interests us most. A few weeks ago, my question of how did I get here was further developed attending the Aaron O. Hoff Awards. Once again, I reflected on what makes our leadership qualities so exemplary and special. The Hoff Awards recognizes students who have strengthened our community through their leadership, inspiration, and dedication to push Lafayette to be better every day. As I listened to the awardees this year, I was in awe. My fellow peers and other numerous student organizations are true change makers, inspiring others to do the same. Over my 4 years here, I have seen students and groups do things that I could have never imagined, providing resources for refugee families in the Easton community, creating spaces for discussions on intersectional identities, bringing awareness to mental illness, and encouraging action to address climate change, just to name a few. Students at the Hoff Awards received recognition affiliated with different leadership traits that we associate here on campus through what is called the 5 Exemplary Practices of the Leadership Challenge. These include modeling the way, inspiring a shared vision, enabling others to act, encouraging the heart, and challenging the process. These 5 distinctions of leadership illustrate not only the vast range of and diverse nature of our student leaders, but also show how leadership can be demonstrated in many forms, both big and small. Class of 2019, we have all engaged in some incredible moments of leadership throughout our time at Lafayette. Through numerous and diverse ways, we have made our campus and greater community better than when we came here. But when we need to build a space for dialogue, we do it. When we aren't happy with something, we change it. And when we put our minds to something that we are passionate about, I don't know about you, but I wouldn't want to mess with a Lafayette senior leader with some serious drive. Though there are countless ways in which I have seen our class and community flourish because of this strong leadership, I want to share just a few examples through the lens of the 5 traits of the Leadership Challenge, which I challenge you to bring with you when we leave here today. Number one, model the change, model the way. Lafayette leaders who model the way help by setting an example for others through their dedication to match their values to action. I think of modeling the way as a ripple effect of sorts, of small acts that can lead to tremendous differences in the lives of others. I saw this firsthand through my organization, Pards Against Sexual Assault, and the peer education group we completed with each NCAA athletic team on campus. The ripple effect went something like this. One meeting with Sharita Freeman, Director of Athletics, turned into mandatory sexual violence prevention training with every single team, which turned into more student leaders requesting peer education with campus life groups, including the marquee players and Greek life chapters, which then turned into twice as many peer education applicants interested in joining the movement. But what was most impressive to me while this ripple effect occurred was the awareness and education emerging around issues that mattered to our community, where the simple acts of enthusiasm from teams who really wanted to talk with us about their opinions and personal experiences turned into influencing others. I saw this with the men's lacrosse team and the incredible conversations we had both during and after our workshop with the players. As an athlete, these workshops with teams were transformative for me. Hearing the lacrosse team talk so seriously about making a difference and challenge themselves and others to be better about toxic masculinity and a culture of silence gave me hope and made me proud to serve this community. They took this beyond their team, though, as they would raise a high five to PASA members on the quad, ask insightful follow-up questions, and even got the whole team to participate in our 5K during Take Back the Night. I've been privileged to see how one idea and action can lead to tremendous differences in our community, and I know that this has happened across disciplines and student groups alike. Two, inspired a shared vision. Taking time to ask thoughtful questions, maintain curiosity, and listen is so underrated and can truly transform an individual from feeling like their voice doesn't matter to actually showcasing their strengths through listening to their ideas and witnessing moments of inspiration. As a writing associate, I've witnessed that the transformative power of actively listening to and building confidence in others' writing. As WAS, we often say, "Why don't you just say that?" Upon reflection, I can see how inspiring it is to just say it and do it by taking that risk, trusting your intuition, asking those questions, and never giving up as we embark on our separate journeys. Doing so can inspire not only others that you work with by showing that you care, but also listening to their stories and thoughts will help you follow your own inspiration. Three. Enable others to act. What I think makes Lafayette leaders so special are the relationships that they form with others. Fostering collaboration by building trust and facilitating relationships is present in our daily lives on campus, but often some of the smaller, more insignificant relationships we form with others go unnoticed. As a partner peer mentor, I've worked with first-year students who have no clue what they want to do or how to get involved. Similar to our own relationships with our faculty and staff, mentorship is crucial to helping others develop and grow. None of us have gotten where we are today without the support and power of enabling others. Take a second to think about who has helped you throughout your time at Lafayette and who you have helped. Whether it was a resilient mother, supportive advisor, or a one-of-a-kind group of friends, we all have people who have helped us enable ourselves to act. And we've done the same for others as well. Never stop doing so. Four, encourage the heart. Class of 2019, we have experienced a grave amount of loss and hardship throughout our time here, especially with the passing of some of our closest friends and peers. While we honor their memories and contributions they made to the world and to others, I have been blessed to see love at Lafayette, love everywhere. When I think back to moments of sadness, I can't help but feel incredibly grateful to have had the community support that we have provided for each other. We have come together and shown compassion and empathy. We are stronger when we can rely on our friends and each other. when we lost two of our classmates, Sarah Bramley and Joseph Kirkpatrick, I saw this love firsthand. Recognizing when we are not okay and when we need to vent, cry, scream, or laugh is very important, and the range of emotions felt after trauma have no guidebook or timeline for healing. Keep creating a sense of community by cherishing every moment we have and look out for each other like I know we know how to do. 5, challenge the process. Finally, and if you know me, this is my favorite, challenge the process. But do so with gratitude. When I was a first year, I took the risk and asked myself, why not email Amy O'Neill, our former Title IX and equity coordinator at the college? I wanted to know more about how our gendered violence policies and procedures, as I had already as a first year seen and heard too many stories of sexual harassment and assault on campus. I noticed a major disconnect between the student body's experiences with such violence and the resources that existed but were not openly discussed or utilized. I challenged the process, but I didn't do this alone. Along with a team of incredibly brave and courageous survivors, we created a peer education group called Parts Against Sexual Assault, which you have heard about today. We challenged the process because we saw our peers and our community members not receiving the support that they needed. But we couldn't do this alone. We had support. Support from our staff and faculty, support from other survivors who willingly shared their intimate personal stories, and support from our own sub-communities of friends and family. I'm internally grateful for the support that I received from this community and trying to give others the support that they deserve. When we leave here today and go out into the world, keep this little bit of Kernan mentality with you as you pave the way for others in whatever you do and wherever you go. Leadership is more than positional, and the very best leaders are mentors, listeners, encouragers, challengers, and doers. As you lead and model the way, inspire a shared vision, enable others to act, encourage the heart, and challenge the process, ask yourself questions like, who is included in this conversation? Who isn't, and why? What is this law, policy, or practice doing right? What is it doing wrong, and what could be improved? Stay critical, stay woke, and most importantly, stay curious, because that's when the real change happens. Congratulations, class of 2019.